inside a shopping mall in Kuala Lumpur, and I just want to show something, and I'll have to be quick because I'm in a grocery store. You'll notice the prices are just, you know, they don't really make a lot of sense. Like this one is 20 ringgit, which is about, so 8 ringgit would be $2. And so you're essentially, you know, looking at almost $5. Come over here, got that one, which is about $2. Now, it turns out you might be thinking that this is, you know, some sort of import tariff, but it's not. This is a much better product. So at first, the prices don't make sense, but it's also because of currency. This is Australian. I didn't bother. Oh, here we go. This is Indonesian. So I don't know whether they're all part of the same trade agreement, but you can see that even if they are, and all these countries are close to each other, it's not necessarily the import that gets you or that determines the price. A lot of it has to do with the fact that you've got different currencies, and each currency is either stronger or weaker based on how much the countries want to export. So in other words, a weaker currency makes it easier to sell your products overseas. So you can see it's not, you know, so again, this is, you know, cheaper. I noticed some Arabic on it, so you've got, but this is a product that I think is actually American. Let me see if I can pick it up. It might not. So it's an American brand, so technically it's an import. I'm just trying to figure out. Sometimes I make it hard to figure out. Here we go. So it is an American product. It's made in Spain, in the EU, and it's still cheaper. So it's not all trade agreements. A lot of it has to do with, you know, just currency, whether you're in an export-based economy, and there's just so many different things that go into it. But right here, you can see how prices make, prices are really fungible, is I think the word I'm looking for. But also it's based on packaging. The packaging here is much better. So it's not just the fact that when you're opening up a new business, you want to just get a good product. You have to get the packaging right. And that's something that Asia has to catch up on. The reason that China is going to succeed in Southeast Asia is because they've already gotten the manufacturing expertise down because of globalization and the fact that they've become, you know, in the same way that Egypt was the breadbasket for the Roman Empire, they became, China has become the manufacturing hub for most of Asia already. So it's already picked up that expertise, except perhaps in packaging. And ultimately, you can see right here, this is a Chinese product, two tubes of toothpaste for, let's see, yeah, $4, a little bit over $4. So you can see that Chinese corporations are actually moving up, and it's going to be very, very difficult for the United States to compete. And because it's going to be more difficult for the United States to compete, except in baby products, by the way, the United States does a pretty good job in baby products just because people don't trust Chinese companies when it comes to things like baby formula and so on. So anyway, it's just a really interesting world out there, but it's not all about tariffs. It's not all about, trade agreements. A lot of it, that's just one component of what determines what you see when you go into a supermarket or any country. And one of the things that I want to explain is that your preferences are oftentimes determined by factors out of your control. By that I mean, not only is it just general advertising that makes you want to buy Kleenex, you know, over another product that might be, you know, a little bit cheaper, but it's just also the fact of what do you have access to? If you, I don't drink alcohol, but if you, you know, you've got, if you're sitting here and you've got access to, I know this is a premium brand, so 14, but if you're in college, you probably can't afford that, so you pick up one of these things. Something I haven't heard of before. So, and that way your tastes get determined early on, and then in many cases, people stick with what they know. Here we go, baby food, I knew it. These are all probably imports. Yep, Dutch. Or maybe it's not, sometimes they give people European names. So it's a Netherlands company, but they manufacture in Malaysia. Anyway, just a little bit of a lesson there. Take care.